Fez, I look in here and I see a beautiful, odd centerpiece in the middle of our studio.
Yeah, remember last Thursday was Fez Appreciation Day?
Oh, yeah. Was it that last Thursday?
Yeah, and you guys brought in my friend the Commish from Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And she claims that I never sent her a centerpiece. When I said, that's my thing.
Yeah.
You know, that I do with people. So we got the centerpiece and this note here along with it.
It says, Fez, Ron, and crew, I just thought someone should get a centerpiece. Thanks for the hospitality and happy belated Fez Appreciation Day, the Commish.
All right, that woman is out of her mind sane if she thinks I never sent her a centerpiece in all the time that I've known her.
I'm going to believe her. I am going to believe her.
Fez. Over me?
Yeah, I do believe her over you because why would anyone lie? Why would anyone lie? That's what I can't understand about the centerpiece story. Hey, Derek, you're on Ron and Fez.
Yeah, Ronnie, I think we need to go with the Van Morrison Day. That'd be a great idea. That was one of the best openings I've heard in a long time.
It really was, and especially Glad Tidings. I haven't even heard that in a long time. And it just had me up. I felt like an Irish traveler. I felt like finding an old woman and separating her from her cash.
Exactly.
All right, peace out. Jerry, you're on the Ron and Fez Show.
Hey, I got a question. Why was Dave singing and serenading Neo last night on Pal Talk?
I know very little about the Pal Talk thing. All I know is Pal Talk is what Dave has shown me. I know a lot of these people spend far too much time not making their beds and just living that life. Who's Neo, Dave?
Neo is everyone's favorite little guy. He stands about 4'2" or so. Uh-huh. And so I thought, you know, it would be special to sing to him. And I might have had a couple glasses of wine.
All right, bad news, she did get dressed.
Standing in a chair.
Yeah, bad news, she got dressed, but off camera. You're not supposed to be drinking during the week, Alki.
No, I didn't drink. I had a couple glasses of wine, so I felt like I would serenade him. It wasn't
he
drink.
He was loaded.
That's drinking!
Two glasses.
It only takes one for you to get rip-roaring drunk, and it was obviously enough for you to start serenading a midget.
No one said he was a midget. He's just short, right?
Yeah, he's just short.
Sorry,
technically
Neo.
A midget?
No, he's not a midget.
Okay. I believe Neo is the one. That's what I actually believe.
I get, you know, even if I have some cough syrup, I start feeling the thing to sing. Anything
that
has
an alcoholic.
Oh,
yeah,
okay.
That's how an alcoholic behaves.
All right.
Yeah, it was pretty bad. He was up in a chair, jumping up and down with a baseball bat, singing to
What time was this?
late last night, midnight.
All right, the chick leave you yet?
No, she was there the whole time.
She likes Crazy Dave?
I would say she liked my whole personality, maybe.
Oh, God.
Well,
I don't know what he
wants. So I think that's the only reason she was liking it.
Oh, God, it's happening.
Well,
what did I tell you yesterday?
Yeah.
And I told you nicely, I go, I don't know how, but I do know it's inevitable that the company will cut you loose one day because of your drunken actions that take place.
Right, yeah, it was so prophetic. And actually, in fact, your words kind of rattled in my brain, and I said, you know, usually at this point, I turn it up a notch.
Right.
I go for the JD or something like that, and we fucking hit it till sunrise. But I decide no. You know what?
But I told you that the day we hired you. I said, you're great. Everything about you is funny.
Yeah.
But I've been around guys like you my whole life. The company always steps in, and they separate you from the show. It's happened to me and Fez a million times.
Right. Well, I mean, I was just singing.
TikTok, TikTok.
Okay.
Oh, boy. He is a,
Well, I hate the cowboy drinking attitude, too. We take it till sunrise. He can't take it past one beer before he's trying to shit on a bar.
Clutch, you're on a Fez.
Hey, I think Fezzy ought to send Neo a centerpiece for that midget comment.
All right, can I just tell you something? And I looked up, and one of the things that Dave put up was an anti-Fez thing I'm not going to put up with. Fez lies about centerpieces, so what?
I do not lie about centerpieces. I have sent centerpieces to people for their dinner parties or whatever.
Even though today is not Fez Appreciation Day, we're going to take it easy on Fez today. You had a bad morning.
Yeah.
I had to talk you off the off the ledge. Had to get you out of the what I call the Jenny shower. You actually crawled in the shower like Rich Jenny. What exactly went wrong today, Fez?
Well, I went to see a therapist today.
Now, this is something we've all been pushing for you to do.
Right, exactly.
Part of your, I don't want to say retardedness, but there's some word that you use. Your problem is you don't even like to talk to a therapist because you feel like you're judged and they reject you.
Right, yeah. So I have that. So it's very difficult. I've gone to therapists before, but it's a difficult process for me to actually pick up the phone, make the appointment, and then go and meet this person. Because it's a while before I feel like I can open up to a stranger like that.
Right.
So I finally got everything together, made an appointment last week, got in this morning to see a therapist.
Now, this should be a day of celebration. We should all be happy.
And I was actually looking forward to taking a positive step and, you know, fixing some things. Got to her office. First of all, she was 10 minutes late. Then I got in there, and she said she couldn't treat me.
You talked to her, right?
Yeah. We sat there. We probably talked for about 20 minutes.
You told her your whole story.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, again, why did she say she couldn't treat you?
So, I was telling her about the anxiety problem, stuff like that, and then I got into the heart attack.
Mm-hmm.
And that sent up some sort of red flag to her, where she said, she gave me two reasons. After talking to me for 20 minutes, she said she would need to see me twice a week.
So, you're not even like a normal person with problems. You're doubled down.
Yeah. For some reason, she said, this is urgent, and I need to see you twice a week.
All right. Basically, you double down.
Right. She says she didn't have two sessions a week open in her schedule.
Not for Bob Wiley.
Yeah.
Bob Wiley, a little too difficult.
Then she said, I would have considered it if there wasn't a medical condition on top of your anxiety.
You're going to drop dead in the office.
So for some reason, this heart attack scared her off, and she says, I need to find another therapist, someone who deals with medical issues as well as emotional issues. So it was just very, very devastating, very disappointing this morning. So, I mean, I went and I got, you know, myself in there and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then, nothing.
Well, maybe the thing is this, Fez. Obviously, she wasn't the person for you.
Right, yeah.
You're too much work. You're high risk.
She said high risk.
Yeah, you're high risk.
She used that term.
The problem is you're a jumper. She knows it. She felt it. But what is
she... In 20 minutes?
Believe me, I was with you for 20 minutes and I wanted out. But I noticed that when they divided up the radio partners, you didn't have anybody else there. You know, it was like when you went to play catch and, you know, before baseball practice. All right, so she says, I can't treat you.
Right.
You're high risk.
Right, yeah.
And you're going to be a lot of work. What did you say to her? You must have said something that just seemed incredible.
I don't know what it was. You know, I said, you know, we had gone over lists of antidepressants I had tried before.
Oh, geez. Why did you tell her that?
Well, she asked.
I know, but still, I wanted you to keep that quiet till session four.
And then it was, you know, she says, give me the symptoms of your anxiety. And I went through all this stuff.
Oh, no. Why?
And I gave her the symptoms.
Why didn't you say you were doing okay? And then once you get embedded, then you tell her how crazy you are.
Then it was, have you seen a doctor to see if this isn't a medical condition?
Right.
And I told her about the heart attack. And that's when, all of a sudden, she, like, stopped writing in her pad and everything.
She hit a button. Guys in white coats are running at you.
She goes, yeah, I'm not even going to ask you for a co-payment today.
So, she didn't even want to, she wanted to strike anything that you've even been in there.
Oh, yeah, because the first thing, I had to fill out some paperwork before I even got to her.
Right.
You know, and she's like,
that's been burnt.
Yeah, exactly. It's like you were in there.
They put it on flash paper like my bookie, where it's literally one quick match and the whole thing's gone.
So, I mean, and she's like, I'm not going to file any of this insurance. I'm not going to make you copay. Let's just scratch it off, she said.
All right.
And to me, it's like, it's not just scratching it off, it's me making my... I mean, I was just drenched in sweat by the time I got into her office.
Right.
Because it just took so much to get in the door.
Right.
And now I got to start over again.
You know, not for nothing. Did she say, here's a name for you? That maybe I'll help you find somebody who's able to deal with the high-risk people?
What she told me was go back to the insurance website.
Yeah.
Look for someone that treats medical, that can deal with a medical condition as well as an emotional condition. That was her words. And she said, if I can't find that, to call her back and maybe she could help me.
Well, first of all, let's suppose you came in there with major burns. All right, you're all burnt up. You go to a regular doctor. Wouldn't that regular doctor want to help you find somebody, even if he couldn't fix your fucking burns? What is wrong with this fucking? I hate to use the word here. If you're any fucking small children, please turn off the radio. Hooah. Radio back on, kids. I'm going to say it in front of you, kids. That's a hooah that he was fucking dealing with today.
Yeah.
You know what to do? Where's this office at?
40th and Madison.
Why don't we do this? We're off here at 3 o'clock.
Right.
We're about 17 blocks away. We'll hop in a cab. Let's go down there. You know her name?
Uh-huh.
Let's barge in and I'll kick her in the cunt right in front of everybody. I'll fucking nail her and drag her around the fucking office and say, how's this fucking feel?
Because that's what it felt like to me today. A kick in the cunt.
All right, watch the language. You don't need to work blue.
I forgot to tell the kids.
Seriously, you don't need to work blue.
Right.
That's not you. This is part of your problems. All right, so you're a place I didn't even expect, Fezzy. You're unhelpable. Which shocks me.
Yeah.
At this point, you're unhelpable. You're not being able to be treated.
Therapists are running the other way now.
That's a bad one.
Yeah.
That is a bad one.
So, it's, I guess I just gotta go back to the drawing board.
Jerry, you're on Run a Fez.
Hey, Fez. I hate to hear you this way, buddy. You know, that doctor, she really helped you out because she didn't, you know, she didn't just look at it as she's gonna take your money because she could have been that way. So you need to look at it as a positive. She's telling you that she's moving you on to somebody that can help you, so it's a good thing.
He will get to that point, but this fucking woman could have actually given him a name. If she would have said, I have a name of somebody, or I want you to check this out, he'd be feeling like, okay, I'm heading in the right direction. But the point is, she just fucking sent him back out on the street.
Yeah.
And I'm a little bit fucking pissed about that. And these fucking, people have a right to know that the guy comes in there, he's all ready, you see what condition he's in. If you can't help him, and I know he's probably over your head, honey, I'm sure you need more of 8 years of schooling before you're going to fucking tie yourself in with a Fez Watley. That's the deep end of the pool. I know that. But help him. Send him somewhere else. Keep him moving.
There was two other therapists in her practice there, and I'm just like, I was wondering, you know, is either of those available? I didn't even know who they were.
All right, did you say anything to her like, hey, I can't go out in the fucking street. Look at me.
No.
I'll fucking sue the shit out of you.
At one point, I tried to talk her in, you know, into still seeing me.
Yeah.
And she cut me off real quick. So then I just wanted out of there.
Oh. All right, how big is she?
Tiny.
Perfect. I will fucking blast her.
She's littler than Neo.
Really?
Yeah.
You know what? I'm going to kick the shit out of her. Just to be sure, I'm going to take Dave with me. Dave, just fucking hang back. And if it looks like I have any trouble at all, I want you to hit her in the back of the fucking legs with a bat. And we will beat the shit out of her, Fez. You will get what you wanted. A therapist beat up.
Just her to feel a little more pain.
A little more pain? I'm literally going to fucking leave her without the use of her legs. All right.
She's little. I'd say probably about 60 years old.
Perfect. I might even toy with her for a while before I knock her out. You know what? Bring a fucking bucket of water, too, Dave. After I knock her out, I might want you to fucking splash her back awake. This may take 2-3 fucking days by the time we're done punishing her. All right. So that's a fucking setback. I'm not going to lie to you about that. I know you put a lot into that. And here's the other thing. If anyone noticed, the last couple days we've had Pepe Fez around here because he felt like he was doing something good.
Right.
Last couple days, everything's rolling off your back. You were talking a little louder. You were walking a little prouder. Everything was going. You got a beautiful centerpiece here.
That's a sarcastic centerpiece.
That makes me laugh, though. I mean, somebody who spends money to embarrass you, that's a friend. You know? That's just not name-calling. That's like, I'm going to go all the way down to the florist. If I can mail something 1,800 miles to embarrass him in front of his friends.
It is a pretty ambitious taunt.
Yes, you got to admire. That's friendship. Somebody goes out of their way to do something like that. That's like somebody skywriting Fez is an asshole. That's a lot better than writing it on a bathroom wall. They've got to really put in something. All right, so this woman's out. This little fucking midget is out. Good. I never trusted her. But seriously, I'm pissed at her, but whatever. That's fucking here nor there.
Right.
You know what I mean? She will die one day, no matter what happens. Now, oddly enough, I was just reading New York Magazine, and there is some kind of place, I think it's in Chelsea, and they have 80 therapists on fucking staff. And you go through a process before they find out what therapist works with you. That's like 150. I don't think they use insurance, though.
Mm.
So, but there's a sliding scale. But I know how much money you make, so you're going to be at the top of any scale.
I'm going to slide upwards.
Yeah.
I'm going to defy gravity there.
But it might be worth the 150 just to go down there, meet a bunch of therapists, tell them your problems. Maybe they can help you find the right therapist. For $150, right, maybe you stop this game that you're having with the phone book, a blind therapist finding.
Yeah, that's a guy. I'd never heard of that. And you're right. It's well worth $150.
Oddly enough, I never heard about it until after I talked about you today. Earl backed this up. He reads this magazine. It's like the best of. Did you get that one yet, Earl?
Yeah, the best of New York.
You got it?
It's in the office.
Go get it. It was weirdly enough. And I thought, well, even if that's not the place for him, I mean, obviously, I know you could afford it even if you wanted to, but I know part of your therapy thing is you're very cheap. But you maybe go down there, meet with this team of people, you tell them all your problems, and let them give you some advice.
Yeah. I like the idea of that.
But I want to tell you something else. I still want us to beat the fuck out of this woman.
And when she said they meet 2 times a week, you know, that was after I had filled out all the insurance and stuff.
Yeah.
And she found out how many visits the insurance would pay for in a year. And I just kind of wondered about that, where it's like, all right, is this, you know, this woman some sort of therapist traveler who's trying to just get everything out of the insurance company?
Well, Fezzy, you know, in her favor there, if she was, she would have taken you.
Right.
You know, twice a week doesn't even begin to shock me for you. I believe we're going to have to get you one of those Brian Wilson therapists who's got to be with you 24 hours a day doing your laundry and co-writing jokes with you. I really think we're going to go that deep. Earl, find out who Brian Wilson's therapist was that ended up with the publishing rights.
That was Dr. Eugene Landy.
And I'll be screaming with Eugene Landy. No, we're not going to do a comedy pyramid. The Hayseeds will fuck it up. I don't care whether it's good for Fez or not. By the way, did you get hold of Wiki about the extra thing? He said today's the last day.
I sent him a list.
You got all the names of it?
Yes.
And I want you to talk to him personally. Stop emailing all the time, Earl, and make sure you talk with people. Hey, Jimmy. Jimmy, you're on the Run of Fez show.
Hey, guys. My girlfriend's a therapist, and basically...
Jesus Christ. That's
See?
Odd.
Same thing happened to me this morning. Except it was a door slamming in my fat face.
The woman actually says to Fez, let me go get a pencil, and fucking dives out the window. And he sees her running through Central Park. Where is she going?
It was so insane this morning. Because I was her first appointment of the day. And so she's 10 minutes late. So I'm just standing out in the hallway of this office building, waiting for her to show up. And I just felt like the biggest creep out there. Like I was... You know, I'm here, Dr. Leo Marvin.
All right, see, that's part of what makes you crazy. You're not a creep for the door not being opened.
Like I was stalking the woman.
You weren't stalking the woman. You're showing up for an appointment.
I was on time.
Hey, Scam, you're on Fez.
Hey, buddies.
Yeah.
Fezzy, I'm sorry, but you cried and rules are rules, and I think I'm entitled to a prize.
Wow, what's it feel like to be an awful person? We'll send you into the big ass prize closet. Get into the awful room. Go ahead, you awful bastard.
I'm going to give you the worst thing I can possibly think of. DVD copy of the
I love you.
World Trade Center starring Nicolas Cage from Paramount Home Entertainment.
That'll teach you.
That'll cheer you up. Paramount.com.
Watch that 3 times a day.
Enjoy.
Garner, you're on a Fez.
Hey, buddies.
Yeah.
Hey, Ronnie, how many therapists do you think that you could beat up?
You know, it's an interesting question. And I mean, I would, you know, immediately I want to say infinite, but I have a little bravado about myself. But I will say this. I don't think I've ever met a therapist I couldn't take. And I ain't saying I'm the toughest guy in the world. I'm saying any guy, regular guy, could probably beat any therapist. But just in case, I'm going to have Eastside Dave waiting by with a stick. And then if things go well, a bucket of cold water to wake her back up again.
This beating could go on all day. I mean, she's not even going to scratch back.
I hope you're right about that, Fez. Lord knows you've been wrong a lot lately, what with picking your therapist and all.
And throw in that psychiatrist from Fairfax, Virginia, too, that crazy old man.
That question mark that kept giving you all kinds of drugs?
He looked like Dr. Whoopi from the Tennessee Tuxedo.
Fez was taking all these drugs that weren't working. Actually, were making him worse. His leg went crazy, you were scratching your own skin off, and you picked up a bad case of Tourette's from it. So finally, I'm like... Let me go down there with you and meet this guy. He's not paying attention to the way you're reacting to the drugs. I get down. It's this little old man with the spine of a question mark. And he was just... What was that character that used to be on the Carol Burnett show?
Oh, Mr. Ted Baum.
Remember, he would just have those little steps.
Tim Conway.
That's how he was acting. I'm like, you're taking your dope from this fucking guy?
That was a mess.
Well, you can pick him, Watley.
And that was just, he scheduled appointments 15 minutes at a time. You had 15-minute appointments with him. How are the pills? Fine. Bye.
Why would you say fine to him? God knows what the hell you were going through.
Well, even if you said not fine, it was just another prescription. Bye.
Brian, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, buddies, how you doing?
What do you say, man?
Fez, look, man, I suffer from a lot of the same things you do, anxiety and, you know, depression, not the gay thing, but this is really the hardest part. I mean, if you suffer from anxiety, this is anxiety personified, especially getting pushed back out in the street, but just you got to just put your head down like a bulldozer and just make yourself do it, and once you get... Maybe into the second session, it'll be, you know, if everything works out.
But here's the reality.
A second session would be a dream at this point.
The reality is this. If the guy was a bulldozer, he wouldn't give a fuck about any of this stuff. You can see he's sensitive. That's the thing that I don't fucking like about these fucking college pricks that are down this. A guy's showing up down here, not because he's annoyed. He's at the end of his fucking rope. You think he wants to be all these things that he's doing... Make him a fucking nervous wreck. He had to take 2 trains to get there. That had him freaked out. He's up outside of his comfort zone. He's standing outside. Help him a little bit, you pricks. What the fuck is wrong with you people? Jesus Christ, a normal fucking person who had no fucking background would say, sit here, let me see what I could do for you. This fucking person who studied the deformed, the disabled, the fucking mad, she's got 8 years of studying fucking these creatures, and she can't come up with, let me give you a Valium and ship you to Bellevue for the next 3 days. Put them in Bellevue. Help them out a little bit. Don't send them back into the street.
When she started talking about how she couldn't treat me,
yeah,
she started by saying, you know, I don't think I'm the right person for you.
Yeah.
And I instantly thought, oh, God, they are going to, like, rush in here in white coats or something. Where she's saying she's not enough for me.
Right.
You know, for treatment. I'm like, oh, God, I got to make a break for the door. Or they will have me in a straitjacket. I was thinking that this could be exactly how this goes down.
I'll tell you what. You ought to fucking shank her. You ought to head back down there and go, I left my wallet here, and just fucking shank her. Here's the beauty of it. I know we could get you off on madness. What fucking person who was this one thing happened to would stab a therapist to death? You'd have to be crazy.
Yeah, your alibi is your victim.
Oh, these sick, fucking awful people.
Well, I do want to thank Tall James from RonFez.net. He sent me a gift today.
What was that?
Out of the blue. This Oreo cookie jar that he won in a raffle. He didn't want it, so he sent it to me.
No wonder he didn't want it. Look at it.
It's a mess, isn't it?
It looks like something you'll give out this next Christmas.
How old is this thing? So I got that and a sarcastic centerpiece today.
Athena, you're on Fez.
Hi. Hi, Fez. How are you?
Good.
I just wanted to tell you, they're totally breaking every rule of ethics by not recommending someone. It's in every professional guideline. If you can't help someone, you have to recommend them to someone else. It's for nearly every profession.
Well, you know what? So. She's fucking around with the wrong guys. Because I have no code of ethics. I'll fucking take this guy back down there, force her across the desk, shove a cock in her ass, and then ask her to fucking fix him. I've had it with these fuckers.
Yeah, you shouldn't feel bad, Fez. She's totally being unethical, and you'll be happy that you found someone.
But here's the thing. The guy's out. He's looking for fucking help in the world. This is the way he's treated.
And then she'll always just say, you know, well, I said if you didn't find anyone, I would try to help.
What a fucking idiot. A scumbag idiot.
She told me to just go back to the website.
Oh, yeah. Let me fucking surf for contentment. You ought to fucking kill yourself right out in front of that place, Fez. Just shoot yourself in the head right and let it fucking go all over her door.
I was thinking about that, too, on the long walk back to the subway.
Suicide?
Well, I was thinking, you know,
oh,
what if some
fucking walk of shame where you had to walk past the real patients.
Yeah, the people that are accepted. So I was thinking, if anything happened to me today, I just hope someone goes back and tells her.
Well, I'll fucking tell her. What an awful fucking skank. A terrible person. All right, you're unhelpable. Let's just fucking know that. Why don't we do this? Earl, get me a fucking clothesline. I'm going to tie him to the front porch, and we're just going to keep him here at home. There's nothing we can do about it. He's unhelpable, but he's ours, and we're going to just tie him up on the front porch every day.
Well, at least you're not hiding me from the neighbors.
What do I care? Let him fucking take a gander. Your family's so perfect, you don't have a retard in it? No, I don't think so. You just accept yourself, Fez, now, as unfixable.
This was a real pain in the ass today. Just an awful moment.
Fuck. What a fucking skank.
She was so concerned about her own, you know, the more I think
safety,
about it.
Safety, I'm sure. I'm fucking terrified to be with you one-on-one.
Not safety.
I'm not going to lie to you.
her schedule. She was more concerned about her own schedule and me having a coronary in her office.
You know what this is, Fez? This is some fucking ham and egg school who don't want to put USC on the schedule. That's all it comes down to. She does not want to ruin her one loss record with you coming in there, fucking probably howling or screaming or whatever you're going to do, scaring away the other patients, and basically making her feel like a failure.
She already failed my book.
Yeah, but, you know, she can go home tonight. Well, I helped somebody with an eating disorder.
Yeah, I mean, it's not even on her record book. She's right. Tearing up insurance forms as I'm, you know, I'm just going to throw these out, she's saying to me.
Yeah, fucking shredder. Went right through a shredder.
So I never
even... You must have put on some acts for 20 minutes. Were you crying there?
No.
Fucking crazy?
I was, you know, when she was telling me, you know, I'm not going to be able to help you, I was, like, doing my best to hold it together.
Did you?
For the most part. Then I, you know, lost it in the elevator.
Started going crazy.
Yeah. Yeah.
Anybody in the elevator with you?
Nah, just me.
Thank God.
I had 11 floors to myself at that point.
I hate when you start howling in front of other people in a fucking tight little elevator.
They tend to freak.
All right, well, you can't be fixed.
That's what it felt like. That's basically what she was telling me. Too far gone.
Lisa, you're on Fez.
Hi, guys. I love the show. I felt compelled to call in because, Fezzy, I've been in your situation, and I'm calling to let you know that you're not alone. This is just an egregious act of the mental health community that happens all the time. I've sat in hour and a half to 2 hour long intakes just to be told, no, I can't help you. Then why are you wasting my time? You know, I've been rock bottom and been on the phone with places just to be told, no, I can't help you.
Fez, this might be the perfect woman for you. You and her seem like you have so much in common.
The unhelped.
It took, you know, embrace your friends, let them help you. It took loved ones getting on the phone and calling these places back and demanding, well, if you can't help, then who can? Because I wasn't strong enough to do it. Let people step in and help you. Let them be the ones, be the yellers, be the ones to make this done. Because
I will.
Unfortunately, it has happened way too many times, and I've just been grateful that there's been someone there to help me who's been stronger, who can yell at the person because they are really committing just a horrible act, and they're not doing their job. So you're not alone, Fezzy.
Now, Lisa, I want you to understand something, too, and I'll do this for you as well. Dave and I will go over there, not even yell at her. We will beat her and rape her. Leave her raped. Sitting there wondering what could have she had possibly said that was wrong to you, that a gang rape would take place just a few hours later.
You don't even mention, you need to mention my name. Just let her think she got raped.
No, I'm going to yell out your name when I come.
Oh.
This is for Fez Watley. Actually, I hope I can even hold it. I'm so fucking excited just with the thought right now. I might have to run off a fucking nuisance batch just, so I don't embarrass myself during the rape.
You know, Lisa, you were talking about, like, the interview stuff. She told, when I first sat down, she's like, the first two sessions are interview sessions, where exactly. We just go through, you know, history, we go through different things just to see what we need to do, what we need. I made it 20 minutes through the first session. Yeah. This was supposed to be a two-hour process.
Yeah, you lost your interview. You failed your interview.
Exactly, and they're not doing their job, and I can't emphasize enough that you're not alone, and I've been in your position. You feel like it's something wrong with you. You know, why are these people rejecting me? They're rejecting their job. They're rejecting their profession, their vocation, and, you know, I'm sorry, I don't mean to just keep repeating myself.
No, you're right, Lisa, and you know what? We do, Fezzy, need to handle this like adults.
Right.
And, like, think it out. Earl, we still have those hedge clippers?
Yes, we do.
All right, I'll cut her fingers off one at a fucking time.
during the rape.
I'm from Delco too, Ronnie. I know your methods. You're a good man.
What part, Lisa?
Other side of Chester Park.
All right. Okay, honey. Thanks for calling. Yeah.
All right. I love you guys. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, Lisa.
Bye-bye, Lisa.
Good luck.
Good luck, Fezzy.
Thank you.
See you at the Granite Run Mall. All right, 866-RON-0-FEZ, 866-RON-0-FEZ. All right, Fezzy, so what? So what?
Yeah.
You're going to stay crazy. Fine. Fine. Let me know if you want to get in on this rape.
No, I've seen her.
That don't fucking throw me off. That don't even slightly throw me off.
Remember the question mark guy we were talking about?
You know,
picture of a female version.
How many times do I got to explain to you that it's not sexual, that rape is an act of violence? I tell you time and time again, and yet you never want to join in.
I always forget that part of it.
Leo, you're on a Fez. Whoop, lost you. Tom, you're on a Fez.
Hi, Ron. Hi, Fez. Fez, look, first of all, you got to understand something. You're looking at this as a negative. It's actually a positive. A lot of these therapists, a lot of these psychiatrists are the most narcissistic, unhelpful people that you'll ever meet. And if she let you go after 20 minutes, you actually won, buddy. Second of all, if you're in New York City and you do have a sizable amount of income, I would recommend that you don't go through insurance at all. You can find a private therapist who will treat you probably 10 times better than anything you'd ever get through insurance just because of the liability.
I gotta agree with that, Fez.
Yeah, I'm on a fairly tight budget, though.
You really aren't.
Well, I understand that.
You really aren't. You fucking, your producer could buy a $240 lunch yesterday. You're doing okay for yourself.
Yeah, and just to get it out of your system, if you do, go ahead and beat that cunt, all right?
All right, thank you very much.
Thanks, Tom. That seems to be the one thing everyone can agree on.
Yeah, no one seems to be backing me up on this rape thing.
I think people are just more into the beating, like that would be enough.
It isn't, though. I mean, that to me is foreplay.
I mean, if you went over there and beat her up, it would be the 101-year-old woman in New York. It would, you know, be shots and a broken jaw.
But that woman did better than that guy fucking thought. I mean, he didn't knock her out.
Oh, she took it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, it wasn't her first time. All right, so Fezzy, maybe this means you're fixed. You went and saw the therapist. It's over. They sent you home. Why can't you take it as you don't even need a therapist?
Yeah, I mean, I guess it's done. I don't need to see her again, that's for sure.
She actually said to you, I couldn't do this once a week, you're going to have to double down.
Yeah, she said I would need to see you at least twice a week.
Wow. John, you're on Fez.
Hey, Ronnie, what's going on? Hey, Fez, buddy, how you doing today? Ronnie, got a question for you.
Mm-hmm.
I was wondering, do you think it would help Fezzy if we played the new Sleeve song? Because I know that song would definitely get me pumped up for a beating or a rape.
All right, why don't we try it, Fez?
I think
why
we should
try. Why don't we try to play a quick version of Mighty Horse Rocks the Fat Ass?
I'll try anything at this point. Graffiti artist and consultant to designer Mark Echo. Oh, he was arrested for spray painting subway cars in Brooklyn.
You know, I'm a fan of the graffiti because I was an old-school graffiti artist myself. My specialty was the peace sign, just the word "the who," the backwards swastika. I'd draw the Roadrunner, just the word "the who," Repent 13, the word "the who." Yeah, those type of things.
The guerrilla movement, that's the way it goes, and it's the art of getting up, getting known, and then you take that vehicle and you go all the places once they know you.
The higher you can tag something, the more respect you're going to get. The more outlandish you tag, the more respect you're going to get in the community.
I know a person, everywhere they go, they tag Mighty Horse Rocks the Fat Ass. Mighty Horse Rocks the Fat Ass.
Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
everybody else can live by the rules, except for the graffiti artists. When you see the Mighty Horse Rocks, you don't spell rocks, R-O-X.
When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
What about my tag, Monkey House? Only I pronounce it like this, Monkey House.
When Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
Monkey House, because that's the name I tag with. Monkey House of D-Sippers.
When Monkey House rocks, he rocks the D-Sippers. When Monkey House rocks, he rocks the D-Sippers.
Mighty Horse rocks the fat ass.
Mighty Horse rocks.
Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
Mighty Horse rocks the fat ass. All right, then here's what I want you to do. I want you to get a plane and tag the sky.
Shot a boo gray.
Shot a bull gray. Did that help you at all, Fez?
You know, I was thinking I ought to just go in there with that thing blaring in a boombox. She wants crazy. I'll just show up there singing and playing that.
Tell you the truth, Fez, you don't even need to. All you had to do was tell her that life story of yours.
All I said was heart attack.
I can't imagine that did it, since she already thought she had to give you 2 weeks.
Then I could tell, you know what, as I think more about it, I could tell she wasn't even paying attention to me, because she's like, would I be able to consult with your doctor, you know, if I have concerns about you? Would you be open to that? And I'm like, yeah. She goes, you know, in case there's a chance you have another stroke. And I said heart attack.
Hey, Dave, you're on the Fez.
Yeah, Fez, you, like the other guy said, you're in the hardest part, but you need to get someone like Earl earning his raise there and have your people contact these people so they know you're important, and stress to them that you want to treat this without drugs, and they'll teach you how to identify the triggers that caused the panic.
White people are so scared of black people.
I think they're only partially responsible for his anxiety.
He said triggers.
White people are so scared of black people.
Guess what? Now she's gobbling yogurt. Wasn't enough. She ate enough Greek food to take care of Sparta last night. It's time for yogurt.
She's eating for 300.
All right, here's the joint I found. Washington Square Institute. Listen to this, Fez. Now, it doesn't cover your thing isn't covered in it. It doesn't go with the insurance. But again, if, you know, if insurance means cheap and shitty, then don't do it.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Don't do it. Yes, it's cheaper to go out and have a fucking lunch at McDonald's, but who wants to do it every day? All right, here you go. You got 80 different psychologists, social workers, and psychiatrists. An elaborate screening process takes the guesswork out of shrink shopping. After a 3-session work up, $150, patients are matched to a practitioner by committee. So the committee sits around, they look at your past, they go, who would be best for this person? What can we do for this poor, pathetic fucking loser, right?
Yeah.
And weighs everything from a client's personal history and goes to his schedule. 9 p.m. appointments aren't uncommon. So, you know, you want to be a second shift girl, you can do that. You're down there crying in the middle of the night.
Boy, I love this.
Yeah. Fees are set on a sliding scale from $50 to $100 based on annual income.
All right, we're definitely going to check this out.
All right, I'll give Earl the number right now.
Yeah, do
Earl,
it.
Go head over and see if you can't get an appointment. Make it sound appointment important. Try to get an appointment for Mr. Watley.
Therapist shot for me.
Let on that you're the gay assistant and you want to do something very, very important. And do me a favor. Get fucking Red out from beneath. I can't have him there. That's what started all the problems yesterday. Here's Cracker. Cracker, you're on my Fez.
Hey, what's going on, buddies? I used to have a lot of issues Fez is having, the therapist and the dope. They had me on 300 milligrams of Zoloft a day. And the pharmacist has known me since I was a kid. Went in there to get it filled again. She said, you know, are you okay? I said, yeah, I guess I'm all right. She said, man, that's way too much what you're taking. She said, I know what's wrong with you. I'm like, well, what is? She said, you're just an asshole, bro. You need to grow up and fucking responsibility for your actions. It was an anger thing.
All right, Cracker, first of all, where are you calling from?
Texas.
All right, here's the thing. The same guy who cuts your hair pulls your teeth, so we're talking about a whole different thing here.
Now, could Earl see if I could get an appointment with Walker, Texas therapist?
Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
It's that simple.
I don't mean to bitch today, but if they could please have consistent levels when they load things in the machinery around here.
That's Red the wine drinker. He's in a whole nother thing. This instant replay means nothing to him. He look at just the writing on it, Fez. The way that it's organized. How many times do we say, this is your contribution to the show. This is for something you feel good about. Forget about it. Don't even bother. Jenny. Jenny, you're on Run of Fez.
Hi, Ronnie.
Yeah.
Hi, this is Jenny. I have a shrink for Fez. I went to him, and he treats you without drugs. And I was treated for post-traumatic stress disorder and OCD.
What was the stress that you were post-traumatic about?
Kid toucher.
Yeah.
I was touched when I was a kid.
How old?
Going from about 12 to 17.
All right, so you had 11 good years.
Yeah.
All right, so, and is somebody in New York?
It's in New Jersey, but I can give him simple directions to get him there.
All right. Hold on, Fez. You think you want to go to Jersey for this?
Nah, I'm not going to take that train ride.
All right, tell Jenny thanks, but no.
I mean, I appreciate it. I don't want to just shoot down ideas.
Right.
But it's Jersey, man.
No, well, you were touched by a kid, and we think Dave was, as a kid, we think Dave was too. Because of the long ping. As a matter of fact, Cabby came out the other night, said, Dave, I was listening to you talk about a thing. I was abused as a kid, pissed till I was 13 years old, pissed the bed. So most of the time, you bed pissers abused as children. Now, Dave, you don't even remember, right?
No, I don't remember being abused as a child.
I wonder if that would hurt your abuser, to know that you don't even remember. That would kill me if I was an abuser.
It just doesn't seem possible. I mean, I had a pretty, you know, nice family and everything.
Mm-hmm. I know you did, Tyler Durden. You don't remember a thing.
I don't think I was abused because I'm just the exact opposite. Pea shy.
Well, that's the thing. You know, any kind of sexual off-putting thing.
Oh, okay.
Even to the point of not being interested. Something could have happened.
Affects that area.
Hmm. Well, the area is actually your brain. Not your dick doesn't do this on its own.
Oh, yeah.
So don't even think about any of this, Fez. All right, I got Earl over there. Don't get him a black therapist by mistake. White therapist.
Yeah, please.
Oh, by the way, yesterday I called Paul Newman the greatest WASP actor. I had no idea about this. I got an email. Half Jewish.
Yeah.
Unbelievable. Now I know, greatest actor ever. Never once did I see him act Jewish. Albert Brooks, I know he was Jewish. Never understood with Paul Newman.
Looking into it, I think his father was Jewish and his mother was like Christian Scientist or something like that.
Believe me, if you're half, you're all, like I told Earl. Dan, you're on Fez.
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah, I just had some advice for Fez as far as picking a therapist. Basically, you got to look at, you know, the therapist qualifications, whether they're a master's of social work, a PhD in psychology, or whether they're a psychiatrist, which is an MD, which kind of focuses more on psychology. And then from there, once when you pick that grouping, what you want, then you have to actually go and meet with the therapist. And it's one of those things that's like trying on shoes. You have to actually go meet with different therapists until you find one that you feel comfortable with.
All right, see, but here's the point.
That's ridiculous.
No one goes to a therapist unless they're on the edge. You know what I mean? Like the thing that you're saying about going and meeting and taking time, I could do right now because I'm not fucking bothered. You know what I mean?
Right.
But if I was at the point where I'm jumping out of my skin, where it felt like I'm fucking over-caffeinated all the time, how the hell can you go do this stuff?
Yeah.
You know, you're bringing up something like that only a person can do when they've got all their facilities about them.
You're not shopping for a dining set where you're just going to...
You should, though. I mean, you're eating off your fucking couch after all these years. It's not right.
I'm more comfortable that way. So, yeah, I mean, it's just, it's a difficult process. And one thing that's got me really bummed out is how good I felt about it 24 hours ago.
Yeah, you're in great mood this week.
I'm like, all right, I did that. You know, I got myself in the door.
How did you find her?
Through the insurance website. And it was one of those things where you just click a couple of things.
Mm-hmm.
You know, like different what kind of specialist you're looking for, the specialty, and then it pops up a list of names. And I was trying to find something around Midtown, too. So it shot out about like 25 names to me.
Yeah.
So I went by the specialty and then also, you know, how quickly I could get there and stuff.
We ought to get a hold of Wiki, Human Resources, to pull that fucking woman's name off the insurance. Say that they turned down one of the people who has insurance. I'm starting to think going through your insurance is the worst deal. Because they're fucking treating you like you're showing up with food stamps.
Yeah, and it was just, and I did that, you know, I mean, yeah, I'm frugal, but also, it's a list, you know, as opposed to the Yellow Pages. It's a place to start looking, and start looking again now.
That kills you, huh?
It just drains the frickin' life out of me. So the way I was able to do it this time was I picked like three off of the list, and what I did was I called and left messages on their machines at their offices over the weekend, and
they're not in there over the weekend.
No, I know, but that way I don't get rejected right then and there.
Oh.
So what I do is I leave the message, and if they have a spot for me, they can call me back.
You're like Earl dealing with our bosses.
Right.
He calls when he knows they're not going to be there.
Exactly. So, and this was the one person that called me back, so. The other ones I didn't even hear from.
Do you even remember how old you were when you got molested?
I was not molested.
Well, this is why it's going to be so much harder.
I have no recollection of molestation.
That's going to make it more difficult to figure this out.
I have a suspect, but I don't have any recollection of it happening.
Rich, you're on Run Fez.
Yeah, Ronnie, I don't understand these guys, him and Earl. They both make tons of money, they never worked a day in their lives, and they got all these problems they can't handle. Sorry.
How do you answer that one, Fez? You never worked a day in your life, make a lot of money.
I've worked.
I mean a real job.
Yeah, well, I guess it's just not the answer to everything. I guess it's not all going to buy happiness. I guess it's true.
You got to spend it before it buys happiness, you cheap bastard. It ain't going to buy happiness in that fucking strongbox of yours that you keep under your dead grandmother's coffin back there at the apartment. Why don't you bury her, you cheap bastard? Why keep her there?
I'm still shopping around on that, too.
Junior in Memphis.
Hey, it's called Been There, Done That. That last guy was an idiot in that if he hasn't experienced this, he doesn't know what he's talking about. I had a major heart attack, actually two in a row, a couple years ago. I actually died, and here I am. And went through the whole thing that you're going through. I still go through it, did the therapy thing, and basically the guy asked me what he could do for me. And it's like, wait a minute, you're the doctor. The upshot of the whole thing is, Fez, that they kind of treat you like a wrecked car and they put the pieces back together, but cars don't have brains and people do. And frankly, you know, a lot of times you're better off to talking to people who have been there. Because, which I have. I mean,
you tried to sign up for a heart attack thing, right? Group. They wouldn't take you.
Right. Yeah. That one. They met at very specific times, other week, and it just didn't fit in the schedule.
It didn't fit in the schedule. That's why you find people that whether you talk to them on the phone or in person or whatever, but just people who know exactly what you're going through because they've been through it, and chit-chat with them and find out, you know, hey, different things work for different people, and different people have different experiences. But, yeah, you know, I mean, you're embarrassed. I was embarrassed to admit to my best friend that I went flying out of a grocery store like a maniac because I was scared to death all of a sudden.
Yeah, panic attack in the grocery store.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah, it was happening everywhere. I never knew where I could go where I wasn't going to totally freak out. I was a fruitcake.
All right, thanks, June.
Okay.
Thanks, fruitcake.
Wow, man or woman? 866-RON-0-FEZ, 866-RON-0-FEZ. Earl's still on hold with this place.
There must be a lineup to get in the door down there.
Anything happening, Earl?
No, I've been on hold for about, 10, 15 minutes?
This is the best idea I've heard yet.
It just seems like it. The odd thing was, you called me this morning, you're a fucking complete panic. I sit back, I'm having some breakfast, I open up my New York magazine, I turn right there. It's like that wallet thing, Fez. Maybe that's supposed to be. You know, at the very least, maybe they help you find somebody around the city because, and I'm not a put-down thing, but because you can't seem to do it on your own. You can't seem to find... This thing has become how long now you've been trying to do this, and it's been very difficult for you.
Yeah, extremely difficult. I thought, all right, the process, I mean, at least that part of the process is over today.
A very weird thing. Last night I had a dream that you quit the show.
Really?
Yeah. And you were actually saying in my dream, you're like, oh, no, this was a long time coming. You're going to do great. I'm like, what are you, kidding me? What are you talking? Where are you going? What, you know what I mean? I was trying to fucking talk you out of it. And you were like so happy that you were quitting the show in this dream last night. And then I called a friend of mine who does dream things. And I go, what does this dream mean? And he explained it to me.
Oh, what does this dream mean?
I don't want to tell you about it.
No, tell me.
He said you're going to die.
What?
Yeah.
That means death?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Just great on top of everything else.
Well, that'll at least get you out of this whole therapist thing.
Yeah, I didn't dream last... I don't think I slept much last night. It was one of those times where I was, like, up every hour on the hour. One of those deals. Just looking forward to therapy day, I guess. I'm too excited to sleep.
Well, I don't know what to tell you, buddy. You have the luck, though, don't you, bro?
Oh, tell me about it.
You really go through it.
Yeah. I started to curse God on the way back to the train.
What did you say to him exactly?
Thanks a lot. Or, what was the other thing? Oh, that's right, you don't exist.
Wow.
Yeah, started to go that direction, and then I just said, why bother? Why bother even bringing it up to the guy? He knows what happened. If he's around.
Wow. Boy, the blasphemy that you and Earl get into just will not end. Just won't stop. There's just not enough... you can do about it. Kent, you're on Fez.
Hi, I was just going to suggest maybe that last caller who had the heart attack and Fez should hook up and maybe start dating.
June? At first I thought it was Radio Shark.
Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
Here is Frank. Frank, you're on Fez.
Hey, Ron. Hey, Fez.
Yeah.
Kind of a serious suggestion is I had similar problems when I was about 30. The only thing that wasn't similar is I never had a heart attack. I went to a psychologist that specialized in child or adolescent psychology. Depending on how far back you think your problems stem from,
you might be able to find a adolescent psychologist that will work with adults, being that the problem stems.
Pediatrician psychologist, Fez.
Well, kind of.
You'll be fucking sitting in there coloring next to all the other kids who've been touched.
Well, it works.
Why did you draw yourself so small in the family picture, Fezzy?
How do you even know about that?
I know I've seen it somewhere. Look how tiny he drew himself.
All right, you've got a mom, a dad, a brother, a sister, and a big lump of shit with an arrow that says Fez. How come?
And steam coming off of it.
Yeah,
that steam is
bad.
My shame.
Thank you, Frank. I appreciate it.
I doubt it.
Let me ask this. Throw this one out there. So the therapist, she tells me she can't help me. Go find somebody else on the website. And she says, now, next time when you call someone and you talk to them initially on the phone, before you even set up an appointment, let them know about this heart attack. So I got to throw that out there. Now I'm thinking I shouldn't even mention the heart attack once I'm inside because of the red flag it throws up. Apparently, this is very taboo in therapy.
Well, I guess they don't want to lose a patient.
Right.
You know, they fucking start to regress you. They're doing some hypnosis. All right, Earl's on the phone right now with the Nut Hut. They might send somebody up here with a butterfly net, throw it over you, and take you away.
He called O'Looney's, thinking it was that was the place.
O'Looney's is where you should go. You should sit there and drink and sob in your fucking beer.
Until I start to feel a little bit better.
Hey, Chris, you're on Run of Fez.
Hey, got three words for Fezzy. Embrace the craziness.
That actually worked for me, Fez.
It did?
I mean, it's honest. Yeah. You've got the perfect nut job card. Nobody's going to come to your house for selling Girl Scout keys. Nobody's going to, you know, you'll be the crazy one in your apartment building or whatever, and nobody will mess with you. You can get away. You can piss yourself outside. Ooh, don't say nothing, you know. He's a crazy one. And they won't ever know that you're really not that, you know. Embrace it. You can get away.
You're like fucking Bedbug Louie. You're doing whatever you want.
I would have to take it up so many notches to be the crazy one in my building.
All right, hold on. We're going to talk to your assistant, Earl. Earl, you talk to this place. What's the name of it again?
The name of it is the Washington Square Institute here in New York City.
Okay, Washington Square Institute.
They basically ask some basic questions about, you know, name, date of birth, what problems they have.
Yeah.
There's some personal information.
By the way, when it gets to weight, fake it. He always likes to go low on that. You can't blame him. Why do they care?
And 331-78 is the...
Wait.
No, birth date.
They're going to call you back on your cell to get some, they need some personal insurance information from you. So
I thought they didn't accept insurance.
No, they had asked about particular, like, out-of-network carriers, and there was some other personal information that I don't know that you can provide for them.
You tell them this is all they got to know.
When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
That's all they got to know. So are they going to be able to take them?
They were very, you know, they gave me some basic outline information. It looks very good right now. And very inexpensive, too. So
how inexpensive?
Under $200. It's going to be like $150.
Well, that's what was said in the fucking magazine.
Yeah, I mean, they're basically, there's like three tiers. It's like a three-week intake process. They're gonna.
You're just reading what I already read first from the magazine.
Basically, that's what they were explaining to me. What's going to happen?
I think you ought to do this for the $150, no matter what happens.
Oh, totally. I agree.
It'll give you something to do.
Just the screening process alone sounds fascinating. Where all of a sudden there's like an NFL draft of nuts, and everyone's picking which one they want.
I do not want Bob Wiley.
Fez Watley, Bob Wiley, it's all the same. Today I was doing the steps.
Jerry, you're on Run of Fez.
Yeah, I'm a, I listen to every minute of every show, and I'm kind of surprised, Ronnie. I listening to Fez today, it's obvious he doesn't want the help. He's not interested in getting better because the attention will totally, as soon as he fixes himself, he's not going to get the attention. He's not going to get the the hugs and kisses from people and these conversations of how to make Fezzy better. And I listen to this on a daily basis, and it's coming out very clear today. And I either, Ronnie, you're playing nice right now, or you're just been hook, line, and sinker yourself, bro.
If you want to be honest, this is my best friend, so I can't be as fucking cavalier as you. I can't act like some fucking listener who thinks he knows this man, okay?
No, but you do, though.
But I'm going to fucking tell you the truth. You don't know fucking shit about him. It took a lot for that fucking kid to go down there and wait today. It took a real lot.
Ronnie, so what are you telling me? The days that you are cavalier and you're willing
I'm
to
fucking
to
telling you what you think you fucking get from this show and what is the fucking true thing of life are two fucking different things.
So we need to
buy your fucking cotton candy and walk the midway. That's what I'm fucking telling you.
Yeah. So we need to learn. All right. So every day we listen to this, we need to figure out when you're fucking playing around.
No shit.
When all of a sudden, when
that's
all of a sudden
fucking
real.
Exactly right, you rube. All right.
Yeah. It's that.
Don't walk the
you,
fucking
right?
boardwalk in Jersey, you that's fucking ham and egger.
Dick, please.
Fuck you. You act
fuck
like
me.
You listen.
You want to fuck me?
I want to fuck you, you piece
you
of fucking
fuck
garbage.
On,
oh, you just went seconds ago acting like, oh, I listen every day. I never I miss don't. A minute, a guy. You don't know fucking shit.
What a dick that guy is.
You all right?
Yeah.
Yep.
What do we care, Fezzy? What do we care?
Right.
So what? You're retarded. Who isn't? Look at Earl. Look at Dave. What do you care?
Retarded was the one thing that didn't come up today. Just high risk.
Let some fucking guy from Jersey hurt your feelings. Some piece of garbage. Go jump in a garbage can, garbage man. Don't let any of these people get on your nerves.
I won't.
Spin and win, motherfucker. That's what this is. Acting like you know. Jennifer, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hey, Fezzy. Hey, Ron.
Yeah.
Hey, you tell, no offense, Dave, but just get rid of New Jersey, if that's the opinion. Give me a break. You, Fezzy.
Hey, listen to the Midwest, you, Fezzy. They're going to tell you.
I like Jennifer.
Hey, I like you too, buddy. And I'm going to tell you something. My family is riddled with anxiety and panic disorders. And
I bet.
It's, you know... So what? Who is that person to judge you when you are actually doing something stronger than most people with this issue do themselves? You've taken such a big step, and thank goodness you got Earl and Ron and Dave to back you up and help you out, and you just keep plugging along and let them take the step for you, man, and let them do this. And just get you started again on it, because I know it felt like a setback today, but that other guy, get rid of his subscription to XM.
Thank you.
Can we do it this way, from this end?
You know, the guy probably just felt like he was going to be funny or fucking, you know, somebody's best friend. Just don't worry about things like that.
I think Jennifer's right about Jersey.
Let's not attack a state, Fez. That just plays into your insanity. A whole state can't be wrong. They're the Garden State. Dennis, you're on Ron and Fez.
Hi, buddy.
Yeah.
Listen, I want to go farther than what Ron has said. Fez, you came up and you very graciously came and said hello to me and my wife at the Comic-Con, and you just made her. You made her so happy, and you make people happy. And I think that you should look at what you did, staying in that office, going and making this effort as a real victory. I mean, you often present yourself as a person that just can't cope, and yet you're putting yourself out there and you're constantly, you know, I hear every couple of weeks, every couple of months, you talk about another effort that you've made to get better. And that's part of the victory. I mean, that's part of that you're able to try and make an effort to help yourself is a very, very positive thing. I mean, if you didn't have that inside you to even make the attempt to help yourself, then you really would be lost. But clearly, because you can, then obviously you're not that bad off. You'll just keep trying until it works.
Thank you, Dennis. I appreciate that.
You're
I don't
welcome.
Know if it was a victory or not, but...
Who's the winner today? Fez is the winner.
Not me.
Earl, who's the winner today?
Fez.
Pick today's winner, Earl.
Fez.
Let me check with Dave. Dave, we all had a race. Who won today?
Fez Watley did.
Fez is the winner. Yay, Fez.
I don't
big
think so.
Big winner. Big winner. Where's the big winner centerpiece? There it is. Put it on your head, Fez. You're the big winner today.
That's a centerpiece of sarcasm.
Yeah. Jeffrey, you're on Run of Fez.
Fezzy, keep trying and all that other stuff. But Ronnie, any chance we bring on Mighty Horse for second mic just for a couple weeks?
When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
It's that simple. It's that simple, Fez.
And that catchy.
Yeah.
That's got to be Sleeve's best, I think.
I don't know. Either that or the absolute worst. I can't make up my mind. It's definitely a slide into insanity. And let me put it, a Pete Rose, Charlie Hustle, Showboat and Pete headfirst slide into fucking insanity. Well, we've just lost it.
Sleeve stuff is on RadioGhost.com, by the way.
Is it?
Yeah.
Brian, you're a man of Fez.
Yeah, Fezzy, why did you leave your therapist you had for your whole life? Jesus, my man.
Oh, okay.
That's the problem. The way you've been talking about the one and the almighty, what can you expect? You're going to have problems. Go back to Jesus, Fez. You'll be fine. It'll all work out.
Well, that's quite simple. I should have thought of that in the first place, Brian.
Yeah, you were mad at Jesus.
Yeah, a little bit.
Remember this, he never made any promises. And he was a rebel, Fezzy. He was a rebel.
They're saying now there was a mistake in that Jesus tomb documentary. That one sarcophagus, or whatever they called it,
Wasn't
Mary. Didn't say Mary Magdalene on it.
What did it say?
It said Mary, and it's two women's bones in it. It's two names, Mary and Martha.
So you're saying... Jesus was in the menages. Well.
Well, oddly enough, Earl knows this. There's Mary and Martha in the Bible that Jesus hung out with. He was like, remember Lazarus coming back from the dead?
To remember him? He owes me money.
That was his sister's.
Sean, you're on Fez.
Hey, how's it going, boys?
Yeah.
I'm from Jersey. I should say, fuck that guy. Hang in there, Fez.
Right, see, let's not attack Jersey. It's a hell of a state.
Thanks, Jersey.
Let me bring this up to you, Fez. Three words. Beaver Brown Band. On the dark side. Matter of fact, that could be part of your new therapy.
Beaver Brown Therapy.
Here's one of the big Beaver Brown hits, though, by the way.
When Monkey House rocks, he rocks the D-Sippers. When Monkey House rocks, he rocks the D-Sippers.
Hey, Fez, here's your friend Helen D., Mikey D.'s lovely wife.
Hi, boys.
Hello, Helen.
Hi, Helen.
Honey, Fezzy, you're breaking my heart. You know why? I'm going to totally come clean, and I completely handled this the complete opposite of the way that you're handling it. I've had panic disorder probably since I was very, very young, and no one knew what it was. Probably kindergarten is when it started. And when I finally had my first panic attack, I was 16. And I didn't know what it was. I just thought I was losing my mind. And you got to remember, this was like, you know, in the 80s. So it wasn't really something that was talked about or discussed or, you know, it was something that was still, at least I felt, wasn't really out there and that nobody could help me. And I really thought I was losing my mind. And it got to the point where there was an entire summer where I just didn't leave my house. I just did not leave my house. and I would make excuses for everything. I wouldn't be able to do anything with friends or family, and I missed out on a lot of life. And it took a while for me to get the kind of help that I needed, but I'm telling you, if you stick with it, especially with today's meds and today's therapies, you will get through this. You will get through this, my friend. And I'm just letting you know that I am absolutely 100% positively there for you, and you can tell me anything because I know that I felt like I couldn't tell anyone.
Tell her all your secrets, Fez. I'll go in the other room.
I'm going to talk all my secrets to someone named Tellin' Helen.
I'm dead serious. It was something where...
Do you have a secret, Fez, something that's really bothering you?
No, not that I'm aware of.
Yeah. No, it's
I think I put it all out on the table here.
What I'm trying to say is I kept it a secret, so no one knew what was wrong. Like, in other words, I can't go do that because...
Your only problem, Helen, is you married the wrong guy. Other than that, everything that you did was right.
Yeah, you got an easy fix.
But you know what's funny is that the one reason why I think that I finally beat this whole thing was I didn't want Lene to be one of, to have this sort of problem as well. But I later found out that it is genetic. And to a certain degree, Lene falls into this little condition every now and then. And I know because I have the knowledge how to nip it and to stop it. But our parents had my parents had no freaking idea. You know, they were like, send her to the doctor. So I was at the doctor's, and basically the doctor was sticking his finger up my butt.
Nice.
Just to say, because most of the times anxiety comes out in children where they are constantly vomiting, they have stomach issues, et cetera.
I wouldn't like that much today.
Well, you know what? I would get on a train, and I would feel like I was dying. I would feel like I was going to go crazy. I would feel like, but I kept it all contained and to myself, never told a soul. So I think that you are, what I'm trying to explain to you is that I think that you are really more than half the way there.
Who's today's winner? Fez is.
No, I'm not.
Earl, who won today?
Fez.
Fez did. Let me check with Dave. Dave, big winner.
Fez Watley did.
Let me check with Pepper Hicks. Pepper, do we have a winner's name?
Fez Watley.
Yay! Big winner. Big winner. You get the big winner song.
When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
Earl, my friend won. Fez.
So it took me 30 years to say this.
That's Helen still.
See, it took me 30 years to say this, and it took you only a few. So I know you've been going through this for a while, and you are going to have little relapses, and it's going to feel like freaking hell, and I totally understand what you're going through. So if anyone can understand, I really do understand as much as you may not think so. So I want you to be able to feel like you can pick up the phone and just talk to me about this
just
sort of thing.
Just talk to Helen.
Oh, okay.
I want you to want me.
And even if it's just, to say, hey, this is what I'm feeling. I've been through so much that I could tell you stories to the point where I felt like I was just going to pass out from my heart.
Tell me more about having the finger up your ass. That's the part I liked.
Well
at least it had a happy ending.
Well,
I always do.
Well, the funny thing was, it was like this really German, old German Jewish doctor who felt like, okay, there can't be anything, there was no anxiety. But like I said, back in that day, it was like, there's got to be something wrong with her stomach. So he would just constantly stick his finger up my butt, and then he would sniff it, which I never understood.
Yeah, it was a pedophile. Alright, thanks, Helen.
Okay, so call me Fezzy, please. I love you. Please take care of yourself, and you're going to be fine.
What time are you calling her, Fez?
I'm not sure. I have to figure it out with my schedule.
Alright, but 866.
Don't you be like that.
Don't you be like that.
I'll call you.
Are you nodding your head yes or no?
I'm nodding my head yes.
No, you're not. I see you.
I know where you live.
Yeah. Bye-bye, Helen.
Bye.
Bye, sweetheart.
Why don't you want help, Fezzy?
I do want help. Professional, not finger up the butt help.
That's the help I'm looking for.
Well, I didn't know I'd have to spell that out with the specialist I'm looking for.
Sniffing this, Miss Helen.
Dr. Uncle.
Looks like somebody's been experiencing sweet tots. Corey, you're on Fez.
Yeah, Fezzy, when those support groups don't work out too well for you, you gotta fucking start a fight club, man.
Yeah. I wouldn't mind having my own soaps.
Oh boy. Here's Rick. Rick, you're on Fez.
She had a finger up her ass. Hey, Rick.
Hey, boys. What's going on today?
Hey.
Hey, I just want to tell Ron that I'm proud of you for defending Fezzy's honor. And, Ron, you are a true American hero.
I might be the hero, but who's the big winner today? Fezzy!
Yes!
Yay, Fez, the big winner. Earl, do we have a winner? Fez!
Fez!
Stop it, Rick.
Dave,
who won? Fez Wadley won today.
Yay! Pepper, read off the winner's name.
Fez Wadley.
Yay!
I appreciate the enthusiasm.
Fez is the big winner today. If you reach into your soul, Fez is the big winner. Why can't you be a winner today, Fez? Why won't you feel good about yourself?
Nothing to cheer about today.
Sure there is.
What's that?
Well, we are going to beat and rape a doctor later on. Dave, come on in here. And in all seriousness, you at times like this, you can find out who your true friends are. I honestly think that's it. Dave, are you willing to go down there and help me beat and rape this doctor?
Absolutely, 100%.
Yeah.
I mean, she's fucking dead.
Thank
when
you.
I fucking get my hands on her, this bitch, I'm going to rip her cunt wide open.
All right, why are you going to yell?
Because
you don't need a word. You come in working blue and you got nowhere else to go.
Okay, but let me just say this. The only reason why I am is because I'm that upset at how she handled Fez Wadley.
Yeah.
On Fez Wadley Day.
Well, today wasn't Fez Day.
Today wasn't Fez Day.
Well, you're hungover.
Well, when
you're hungover and your headphones fit you stupidly.
It's the wine talking.
You know what, Fezzy? Sometimes you just need a hug. I got somebody that just came in. Just please give him a big hug. Look what his big A!
Oh, big A!
Big A! Oh, big hug!
Ow.
Nice big tighter big A.
He's all over
tighter
me.
Hug for the winner.
He's on my
tighter
set.
Hug
get
for the
him
winner.
Off of me. He's
thank
on my
you.
Set.
Big A. That's what you need from time to time, Fez. Just a big hug from a big guy.
Thanks, Big A.
Richard J., you're on running Fez.
Hi, Fez. I went to that doctor, and she recommended I clean my shotgun in the shower. I wish somebody would have made me a winner, and then I wouldn't be in limbo right now.
Don't even pay attention to that, Fez. By the way, Richard Jenny's family came out and said Richard was a sick guy. He'd been dealing with depression and, I guess, paranoia for a long time. It had nothing to do. They're like, he wasn't a little blue. He wasn't upset about his career. He was ill. He was a sick person who wasn't thinking right.
His family actually described it as psychotic paranoia. I mean, that's incredibly mentally ill. And then that's what happened. So we can never listen to another thing Elaine Boozler has to say.
When did you ever? Whenever once did Elaine Boozler ever make you laugh?
We can't trust booze anymore.
Yeah. Here is John. John, you're on Fez.
Hey, Fezzy.
Yeah, buddy.
Does you know, everyone calling you a winner and stuff, that's not really making you feel better right now, is it?
No, not really. I don't feel like a winner, John.
No, I understand that. And what bothers me is that, you know, it doesn't seem genuine. You know, the people around you, should they really care about you, they shouldn't be enabling you're not feeling well and where you're at right now and be condescending with calling you a winner. They should really be trying to help pick you up by your bootstraps. And you should look around. and you should really think about it. Because when does it bother you when Big A comes in and he's the coolest and they tease you about that stuff?
So you think we made him crazy?
I'm talking to Fez, Ron.
Oh, is this the John who called before?
No, that guy was Jerry, but what is the deal with these Jersey people?
Yeah,
I think John's a neighbor of Jerry's.
No, seriously.
You know what I'll do for you, John? I'll give you his fucking home number. All right, tough guy?
I'm not playing.
I'll give you his fucking home number. Jesus Christ. The guy had a fucking down day today. We're getting him a fucking other shrink. Stop being hard on him.
It's ridiculous. I don't know where it's coming from.
What do you say to these people, Big A?
Actually, there should be no place for these people, you know. The negative, you know, negative Nellies, you know.
Big A.
Big A.
Big A.
Wraps everything up very quickly with negative Nellies.
That makes sense, Big A. I gotta give you that one.
You could be the next Big A if you just focus on it, Fez.
We already have a Big A.
Who's that?
Big A.
Oh, yeah, right. Big A.
Big A.
Big A.
Big A.
Big A.
No, you listen to them. You're going to go to this Washington Square Park thing.
I totally want to do that. Yeah. I mean, there is no dragging my heels, no hemming or hawing. I want to go through this experience.
Of course you do.
Earl, you got to get me in there. I'll give you my insurance card if that's what they're looking for.
When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
It's that simple. Loving that song, Big A?
Yeah, it's a very catchy tune, actually.
It really is.
Actually, it's a catchy tune.
Yeah, it's very rave.
Yeah.
It just really makes me feel like the old days. Just rolling, fucking relaxing with a glow stick, and just taking it easy for the rest of the night.
When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
And the thing is, Mighty Horse is real. People don't even know that. People don't even know Mighty Horse is real.
I thought it was just legend.
Donovan, you're on Run Fez.
Hey, guys. Hey, Fezzy, I just wanted to let you know, man, we all love you. And when you start feeling down on yourself, just take a minute, stop, and think about the teachings of Monkey House and Mighty Horse, and all will be right with the world.
When Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
The Ron and Fez Show. You know, if you've been keeping up with Fez's problems, you had a bad morning today, Fez. You tried to get a new therapist. The therapist listened to you for 20 minutes and sent you away.
Sent me packing out the door, Ronnie.
Mm-hmm.
And I have a little I've gone to therapists before, but it's always an ordeal for me. I don't even like picking up the phone and making the appointment.
This therapist said you were too crazy for her.
Well, what she said is she said two things to me. She said that she would have to see me twice a week to treat me.
Double down.
And she didn't have that much time open in her schedule. The other thing she said is when she found out that I had had a heart attack a little over a year ago, that I really needed somebody that could handle medical conditions, treat medical conditions as well as emotional ones.
So your emotions could actually give you another heart attack is what she's worried about.
Yeah, she used the term high risk on me.
So you came back from that this morning and were, I think that you were high risk as well, but only sexually, because you're in that group that, you know, doesn't pay attention.
You can't catch a heart attack.
You were pretty downtrodden, dejected.
Devastated.
Yeah.
Disappointed and the worst part of the whole thing was thinking about having to go back to the start and, you know, do the whole process all over again.
All right, so you were pretty upset. Oddly enough, I saw this thing in New York Magazine because they did their, what is it, like the best of...
Best of New York.
Best of New York 07, which I don't know how you can figure out till the... At this point of the year, but they gave it up. 3 months in, we have the best in New York. Now, they had a thing that they said was great therapy. And do you remember what it was? Was it Washington Square, Earl?
Yeah, Washington Square Institute.
Yeah. And there's 80 different therapists, shrinks, doctors all working there. They give you some kind of a three-step checkout plan. Fez, I gave you the number. You gave them a call. What happened?
What I did is I talked to a counselor on the phone, and I am set up for my three-session intake plan, is what they call it. So the first time is with a counselor just to go over some history and discuss some of the problems, things that I want to work on.
Mm-hmm.
Session two is with a psychiatrist to start discussing meds or, you know, not taking meds. And then session three is when they finally get you together with a counselor and they tell you exactly what your plan's going to be when you get it all formalized.
So that all worked out for you. You feel good about it.
Yeah, I'm actually very excited about this. That, you know, I was, because when I left that office today, that lady this morning, I was like, all right, it's going to be another 3 months before I can muster up the courage, the stuff to go through this again.
Well, you found out about these other people, and it feels like it could work, though, right?
It sounds perfect because they do the screening thing.
How did you find out about them?
I found out about them through you.
Really?
Yeah, you told me about this thing.
Wow.
About the Washington Square Institute.
It's almost like Peter Pan or Superman. I came to save you, Fez. Yes, there are heroes in this world. Dry your eyes, little girl. I've got just the perfect place for you. I read about it in New York Magazine. Stop crying, ma'am. I know where you can go.
So I would never have known this was going on in Washington Square if you hadn't told me about it.
The only problem is they take August off. All right, here is...
What, they want New Hampshire all to themselves?
Todd, you're in Ron Fez.
Hey, how are you?
What can we do for you?
There's a couple of things I wanted to say. About a psychiatrist, they're going to take out their prescription pad as soon as he walks in because what psychiatrists do, they prescribe meds. I've been going to a therapist, and the first thing they teach you is to be honest with yourself. And if Fez has to use his real name in the closet, that may help.
All right, so you think part of what has Fez crazy is that he's not honest enough?
Not honest at all. He walks around with a phony name.
True.
So his life is a lie.
Your life is a lie, Fezzy. If that is your name.
My life is not a lie.
Why don't you have your name legally changed to Fez then?
I'm not.
One way or another, you've got to stop living a lie. What else should he do?
What's the secret of his sexuality? Is he gay or not?
He doesn't know. That's what the psychologist is for.
What are you, a therapist, Todd?
Well, where's the honesty? Come tell people.
Oh, you know what? When I go through this intake program, no one said I had to be honest with Todd from New Jersey.
What about Todd from Florida? Should you be honest with him? Hey, by the way, I don't know how this is happening, but there's a floating urine bottle that says I Heart Fez on it.
What?
In front of Alki. I don't know how this happens. Is that CGI? What is that, Dave?
And it's a wonder I'm seeking out therapy.
How does it float like that?
Oh no, that's pretty wild stuff there.
Tom, you're on Ron and Fez.
What's up, boys?
Yeah.
Listen, Fezzy, I really honestly hope you appreciate the fact that you have a friend like Ronnie that's there for you, that's trying to look out for you. It's one of the most touching things I've ever heard, and I hope you appreciate it. You owe that man your life. I hope you realize that.
You know what? I don't.
Saving his life.
Fezzy, I don't think you owe me your life.
You don't?
I think you owe me $400.
$400?
Well, isn't your mental health worth $400?
Well, the whole intake process is only $150.
Oh, so what's that, $50 an hour?
$50 a session.
You should pay me $50 for every hour I'm on the air with you. $50 an hour.
That's six a day.
Yeah, that's a start. Because I know this thing's going up to a C-note, though.
I don't even know what that would be a week.
Show you, though.
Oh.
It's easy enough. Here is Tim. Tim, you're on Fez.
Hey, what's up, guys?
Yeah.
Hello?
What can we do for you?
No, I just was talking about, I just started medication not too long ago. With depression and stuff.
Yeah.
How's it working out for you?
Absolutely amazing.
Can I say the name of the drug?
Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, what you taking?
Cymbalta.
Travolta?
John Travolta is the drug, Scientology.
Cymbalta.
Right, John Travolta. Staying alive with Travolta.
But it's absolutely amazing, you know. Complete difference in what I've how I've been. So.
All right. The reality is this: Fez, when we lived in D.C., he went on so many drugs, and whatever they're supposed to do, he acted just the opposite. I almost thought, and this is a total shoot right now, I thought we were going to have to lock him up because you were going out of your gourd. You were going crazy. You couldn't stop yourself from moving. You had picked up so many ticks. It was frightening.
Yeah, I was basically, my leg couldn't quit shaking.
Yeah.
You know, if the leg wasn't doing it, the hands were doing it. I would get stuck on a word and just rock back and forth in my chair repeating the same word over and over again.
Yeah.
Like it would happen at the computer. I'd check in the email, and I'd just check in the email, check in the email, check in the email. Just rocking back and forth. Whatever happened to get stuck in there at the time, it would happen while I was driving. The night terrors were insane.
What's a night terror?
A really bad nightmare.
Oh.
So,
it's just a nightmare.
But, I mean, just melting
check
faces.
Check in the email.
Fez, by the way, guess who's devouring an entire cheese pizza right now? Little, and I wish I was making it up.
Let me guess, she's happy about it.
Mm-hmm. An entire cheese pizza. Like it's nothing. John, you're on Fez.
Hey, Ronnie, why don't you take out a life insurance policy on Fez for like a mil and cash in on his death?
John, let me ask you something. Who would insure this guy? Can you imagine one place out there that would insure him? I cannot think of anybody.
There's going to be a physical involved.
Here's Bob. Bob, you're on Fez.
Hey, buddies.
Yeah.
Hey, I want to warn Fez about a lot of these antidepressant drugs. They really mess with your libido as far as finishing.
Well, as of right now, I don't plan on taking any drugs. I know what they've
or
done to
finishing.
Me. I know what they've done to me in the past, so I really have no intention.
The odd thing is I plan on taking lots of drugs, and I feel great right now. That's the weird thing about it.
Sometimes we're so opposite.
Isn't it odd?
It's very strange to me.
And when I do feel good is when I want to take drugs. Adam, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
How you guys doing?
Don't worry about us, Adam.
I just wanted to say, I myself used to take an antidepressant, and it made me absolutely insane. I know many people that are on these drugs. I'm actually in the medical field, and doctors love to overwrite these prescriptions, and they misdiagnose very frequently. If you're going to take an antidepressant, I would get at least a second opinion. Just be very wary of what you're putting into your body. There's nothing that you can't fix with proper diet and exercise.
You don't want to do that, do you, Fez?
No way.
The two scariest things.
Give me the pills.
You know, and you said that when you were taking these drugs, you would keep having the same phrases going on and on in your brain?
Always.
I hope that doesn't happen to you again.
When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
Why'd you stop talking?
Something like that.
When Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass.
What's that about?
I just get stuck sometimes.
Here's Frank. Frank in the story. You're on Ron Fez.
Fezzy.
Buddy.
I can relate. I had a lot of the same symptoms. I have panic disorder. I get anxiety attacks and so forth. And there was one tape. I've been working on myself for years on this thing, but there was one tape that they actually advertised on your 92.3. It's the Lucinda Bassett collection. It's a self-help tape that they advertised, and it's helped me tremendously.
I was on the Carling Bassett tapes, but that was just to become a better tennis player.
Mm.
Have you ever tried these tapes, Fez?
No, I've never tried these. I have no idea about the Lucinda Bassett program.
I feel good. I feel wonderful. Jason, you're on Fez.
Hey, buddies, what's up?
Yeah.
Hey, Fez, I got one word for you, buddy. Shatabugre. I-57 Ignite.
I feel
10 times better.
Since I got on I-57 Ignite, I've killed my neighbor's animals.
That's good?
I-57 Ignite, Fezzy. I can't say enough good things about it.
It's a rocket boost, that's for sure.
It brings out the coyote in me. I-57 Ignite.
So I'm not sure exactly what I'm going to go through in this three-session process.
Don't even worry about it.
But I'm interested to see how it turns out.
Why? Stop looking ahead. Take this as a little victory that you've already done it. Don't worry about what's going to happen next month. Today, you felt like you had nobody. Now, you're all happy. You got three different appointments. Be happy for a moment.
Three different appointments and a cast of 80 specialists.
That's all you've ever wanted. 80 people talking about you. Lou, you're on the Fez. Hey, Earl, by the way, do we have an entire cheese pizza?
No, we don't.
Everybody else does. Everybody else sits there in their orange kitchen just eating cheese pizza after cheese pizza with their big giant urine bottle, and everybody else is happy. What do you need, V?
Hey, what's up, guys?
Yeah.
Hey, Fez. It's funny you said Lucinda Bass. I had the whole pile of tapes right in front of me right now. I tried it. It really wasn't that great. But the relaxation cassette tape, maybe I'll even give it to you. That works. It's pretty cool.
I love relaxation tapes where you kind of, it's a guided meditation.
Yeah, well, no, it's just like very soothing. You know, you close your eyes, put your, you know, the headphones on, and
I love to do that when I'm driving. I just put on those hypnosis tapes.
Hey, don't do it then.
Hey, yeah. You know what, Fez? So just back to a couple. I have a couple things to say. First, I was going through symptoms like you were, depression, major depression, and also panic attacks. And it took me. Family members were getting very concerned. They're trying to push me into going to things and stuff like that, and friends and all that. Then I finally had the gumption to do it. And I went to a psychiatrist, and we got along very well. I mean, I was there for like maybe 10, 15 minutes. You know, I kind of connected with the guy. I thought he was, you know, hearing what I was saying. And then he asked me if I drank, and I said, yeah. He says, well, then I can't help you then. I said, why not? I said, he goes, well, I can't help you with that. You gotta, you know. So I said, well, okay, can you recommend someone to help me? And he says, no, I can't. And he says, yeah, go on the website and find someone else. And I'm like, gee, you know, just like you felt. Like, what the hell's going on? I'm going for help, you know?
Right.
And he says, and then finally, he finally says to me, listen, I would love to recommend someone to you, but I can't, because if I do, what happens is, if something happens to you, okay, he's liable for malpractice, which I think is BS. But that's what he said to me. I mean, so, but you, Ron, even earlier today in the other show, talking about, like, you know, just getting blown away. I walked out of the office. I was, like, ready to cry. I was, like, you know.
I did.
I know. I mean, I was in a fog the whole freaking time. It was a horrible, horrible feeling. Just what the medication says, believe it or not, I got my medications to my regular doctor, right, which was probably the wrong thing to do, but they gave it to me anyway. And first I tried one, and one worked to a certain extent, and I had to up the dosage, unfortunately.
That's what I always do, up my dosages.
Then after a while, it didn't work, and then I switched to another one, the Z one, Zoloft, which was the freaking worst. I was shaking my legs. I was at night. I was sweating. I was having horrible dreams, freaking out. Then I switched again to Wellbutrin because they said the sexual side effects wouldn't be there, which was true, and it did work for a while. But after a few years, it didn't work. But now I'm on one that's like a mix of anti-anxiety.
So this is what you got to look forward to, Fez, one drug to the other.
Yeah, just night after night of night terror and sweats. Wait, no, until we get it just right, till I find out I need a Flintstone chewable.
And your crank not working anymore.
But the one that's working now, I mean, but take this into effect. There was one that was really bad that was noticeably bad right away. It does take a while for these things to work, though.
Fezzy, I thank you very much.
Lexapro.
I appreciate
Lexapro.
Now, Fez, I could probably get you through the guided meditations and take you to a place you need to be.
Oh, could you?
Why don't you just relax for a second?
Okay.
Just breathe in and just think of yourself as being one with the planet right now. You're a living organism in a planet that you absolutely belong in. And you can gain strength through one phrase, and one phrase only. Because you, Fez Watley,
every day are getting stronger and feeling better in every way. And every time you hear,
"When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass."
And just let yourself think of yourself as a mighty horse.
A mighty horse.
Running down a beautiful field.
I'm
field of clover and green grass, weeds. You're just feeling stronger and better. Okay. Say stronger and better.
Stronger and better.
And when people see you, they all shout,
"When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Mighty Horse rocks, he rocks a fat ass."
And that every day.
I'm a mighty horse.
You're rocking more and more fat ass.
I can rock the fat ass.
That's you. You are a mighty horse. Rocking a fat ass. And uh-oh, who's that? I think it's your best friend. Swinging from a tree.
"When Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass. When Monkey House rocks, he rocks a fat ass."
There you go. Feeling stronger and better all the time.
The Monkey House is my friend.
Like a big sissy. Like a big sissy who needs to close his eyes and tell himself stuff.
I'm getting uncomfortable again.
Other than a retard, who else would need a guided meditation? Just you. Just you, Waterhead.
I think it's time to turn the tape over.
Listen to your brain. Shaking the water back and forth. Finding yourself becoming stupider and stupider all the time. And more dependent on tapes and drugs and wacky self-help books that nobody seems to care about except for Oprah.
I'm so unrelaxed.
Think of all the money you've spent trying to just feel like a normal person, but you weren't made normal.
That's money I should have saved for when I'm old and alone.
Who says you're going to get old? With your help.
Now the tape's answering me.
I don't see you making 50. Hey. Isn't it odd that as you're laying here, every heartbeat takes you closer and closer to the grave? Every heartbeat is a better chance of you being buried. And sometimes I wonder, what if you were buried alive? Maybe they only think you're dead, but you're in a coma. And when you wake, you're in that coffin, scratching and trying to get out.
It's really starting to beat faster now. A lot faster.
Breathe in deeply while you can. Not a lot of air in that coffin. Barely any. And relax. And take yourself back. Back to a happier time. Childhood. Back to a time when you were around an adult that you did trust, and yet he did some awful, horrible things to you, and then blamed you.
Uncle Jack?
Oh, don't bring up names now while we're on the radio. Think about it later when you're in the coffin, trapped. You think about it, the planet itself is a coffin. There's not much air here, and Al Gore tells me that we're using up what we have.
It's a big blue coffin that's made up of 75% water.
We'll take a break now. While Fez contemplates, why bother living when he's going to die? And everyone he knows or has ever cared about is going to die.
Mama?
Someday, this planet will be nothing but dust and ice. Again, like it started. In a cold, godless universe. It's the Ron and Fez Show.